Pakistan Army on the line of control opposite 15 Corps zone in the Pakistan illegally occupied Kashmir sector. The launch pads for infiltration of terrorists are full, and every night they are attempting to launch the terrorists into Kashmir Valley with an aim to disrupt the peace and the harmony which is existing in the valley. And last 30 days of no incident from the security forces side and no civilian casualties. All the 5 casualties which have happened so far, it may be of a shopkeeper in Parimpura, it may be of 2 Gujar brothers which were killed by a terrorist on the higher reaches, it may be the driver in Beej Behara, Noor Muhammad, it may be the boy who got hit by stones and succumbed to his injuries today after about 25-30 days. All the 5 terrorist-related incidents which have happened where 5 civilians have been killed in last 30 days have happened either because of stone pelting or because of terrorism. So Pakistan is not able to digest this fact that 30 days of peace has prevailed in Kashmir post 5th of August. So he is making every attempt to infiltrate the maximum terrorist, as also his army is supporting, housing and guiding the terrorist right up to the line of control. But notwithstanding, all their efforts are being foiled and infiltration attempts on the border are being contested and addressed in the befitting manner.
Since you talked about the infiltration and now you have arrested 2 of the infiltrators who are from Pakistan, can you brief us about them also?
The 2 terrorists of Lashkar-e-Toyba who were apprehended at the line of control on 21st of August in the Gulmarg sector, they both are trained Lashkar-e-Toyba terrorists who have been trained in the terrorist training camps, and they have also given out the names of the instructors who happen to be from Pakistan Army, the regular soldiers. They were housed in the Pakistan Army post close to the line of control, and they were guided by the Pakistan Army right up to the line of control. That is when we apprehended them. They had some very nefarious designs, very sensitive details have come out in the initial questioning. However, the detailed investigation will be done by the specialist agencies as and when they take them over.
Chief, when we talk about the infiltration or the infiltration, then comes the ceasefire violation. Particularly, you pointed out in Gurez sector, the locals were targeted, their houses got damaged, the compensation was provided. Any other ceasefire violation that was conducted post 370 article scrap?
See, after the 5th of August, the ceasefire violations have happened in Uri sector. There is a village called Churanda, which is near the line of control. That village has been targeted by the Pakistan artillery and the mortar fire. Even in the Gurez factor, in the area of Baktor and all, the villages on side of the line of control have been targeted, where, as I told earlier, 2 civilians have been injured, 8 to 10 houses have been gutted. And this has happened by the Pakistan artillery fire, which was targeted and which landed in the villages on site in Gurez sector. Notwithstanding, civil administration acted in a very swift manner. The divisional commissioner, the deputy commissioner, was on the site the very next day. He inspected the thing. He gave the on-the-spot compensation in monetary terms, as also certain administrative and ration items were handed over to the affected families on the spot, and additional bunkers, the underground bunkers in the villages for the protection of the civilians at the time of ceasefire violation by Pakistan, when their RT or mortar fire hits the villages, has also been announced, and the 76 crore rupees have been sanctioned for those underground bunkers to be constructed in these villages close to the line of control for safety and well-being of the population in that area.
Chief, since there is a communication blockade, not all communication lines have been restored. So how do you deal with the fake news when it comes from, whether it was the Gulmarg or something else? How do you deal with such situations?
See, Pakistan's propaganda machinery is working overtime to spread fake news. Even you are aware, certain videos of the past, certain videos which are not even from the Kashmir, certain videos have been picked up from the clips from the Hindi or Bollywood movies, and certain videos even of the Pakistan-occupied Kashmir and the agitations there have been picked up. They are dated videos, and now they are being projected as if they are the recent videos of the today's Kashmir. All this is a fake news, and we are very transparent in our operations. And at every time, whenever such a fake news comes up, we have a ways and means to address, even through the media. Like, we will bring it out to your notice. Like, there was a picture when a local boy had joined the terrorism in the about 4-5 months ago. That was wintry months. The mother had appealed to everyone for a child to be brought back. In that picture, the woman is having the blankets and the quilt. That showed it was the month of February, March. And that picture, we got that boy back. Okay. After the appeal from the mother or appeals to the mothers, which I personally am a very, very big proponent, that mothers must encourage the children to get back. I again, once again today, would request the mothers of Kashmir to tell the children to get back to the mainstream. So this picture of winter months when this mother requested for the child to come back, the security forces assisted and facilitated the return of the boy to the home safely. Now this picture was tweeted again as if the picture is of this date, that is the summer months, and the lady is saying, my daughter is pregnant and no assistance has been given to her, the lockdown is there. So this type of fake news is being circulated by Pakistan every day. I'm giving you specific instances. And that blanket was still there even in the month of August. And the quilt was there. So this is how then we compared this, we tweeted this picture through our ADGPI and other offices, and the lie was brought out.
As you talked about the fake news and the way it is being circulated, how do you see the reports being filed by the international media, be it Al Jazeera, the BBC, or we talk about the Wall Street Journal? Last time they pointed out that the Kashmir hospitals are flooded with dead bodies, or the Al Jazeera is showing the protest, or the BBC is filing something. How do you react, and what would be the message to such media who are working from across, those who are not here? They are the international India. When you have the local, you have the national media present on ground who are getting the press conferences, feeds, everything. But they are also reporting the other version. What message would be given to them, and how do you react to such reports?
See, firstly, you are a local, you are in Srinagar, you move around every day, and you are free to go to any place. You tell me how many dead bodies lying in the hospitals have you seen? Or how many people have come to you, here is a dead body of my family member, and this has happened because of this reason. So this best answer to this fake news is the truth and the transparency. And we are very, very transparent in our operations, and the truth always prevails. Ultimately, everyone gets to know the Kashmiris are a very intelligent society. They get to know exactly what's happening on the ground. And if this type of dead bodies are lying in the hospitals, the way Al Jazeera or all the other channels, which are, or the reporting channels or the media houses which you are named, if that they have found truth in their statement, the people would have been on the ground, on the streets. Since there is a peace and calm and no one is anguished, no one is, you know, agitating, this shows that there is a total peace and there are no human rights violations happening and there are no excesses happening on ground.
One last question. Since the anti-militancy operations we have, it seems that they are on hold. So we are getting to news that some CASOs are being launched, but we have not seen any militant in a way neutralized the way it was in June, brother, because after the Amarnath Yatra, we have seen that operations went and were not there. So how is the anti-militancy operation that time functioning, and what about the network of militants or the OGWs, because since after the communication blockade?
See, I can confirm to you the counter-terrorist operations are going in full swing as heretofore. Notwithstanding, there are always phases of ups and downs, or there is a, you know, sine cover curve. Today, the counter-terrorist operations are going on as always. However, the number of terrorists getting killed in the recent past is less as compared to the earlier months. So that does not mean the counter-terrorist operations are not going on. Even today, I can get our information now standing here. The contact has been established and so many number of terrorists have been killed or eliminated. So it's just a matter of time as to when the, you know, results start coming in.
So are we in these months, any surrenders that had taken place?
Yes, total of 41 surrenders or apprehensions have happened, even the return to the families after the appeal to the mothers, as also the, you know, the facilitation or the efforts of the civil administration, the civil society, the village elders and the family members.
It's a very good
number to say that 41 terrorist local boys have returned to the field, have returned to their homes, and even now our maximum emphasis is on the local boys to get back to their families, and we are making efforts and we are making it easy for them to return if they want to.
Chief, is it the number is from 1st of January or it has happened in just...
Yeah, this is the number of this particular year, 2019.
Thank you so much for talking to Republic.